I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich. Throw that to the side. Yo. I get those goosebumps every time. Yeah, when you're not around.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, it's not a nice day. Me and my cousin at the fun fair. We had near death experience. So at the Max Giant swinging thing, I have this crisp pile here. It's just too scary. I need to just get some of this. Yeah, so at that Max thing, so you know where the thing closes, the machine, as the seatbelts for safety. Well, when that closes, I peeked my head out like that to see if the guy was gonna close. As soon as I did that thing closed and my neck was staying out. So I used all my strength, I pulled it up, and that thing's really hard. And you know, and it's plus one biceps. Me and my same happened to my cousin as well. He was looking what's happening. So my neck is there and that thing closed like that. So I pushed up, quickly put my head and then just left it and then did that, and same happened to my cousin as well. That was a scary day. Whew. Wait, I'm just kidding. Wait, I don't think I'm close enough to the camera. Alright, that'll do. Turn that thing level down. Jeez. My face is burning. Alright. Put it on minimum. Okay. Alright, so that was a near-death experience that me and my cousin had. I just can't forget about it. My long draft neck was just like that, and I make so much of a big deal of this. Why I was looking at the guy, because I always have a feeling like, oh, that guy's gonna forget about us and he's just gonna go. So I was looking at that, boom, right, this thing's still burning my face, dude, just chill. If you guys are asking why am I sitting like this on the chair, I just feel comfortable. Yeah. I want to just see how many comments is it going to say thing. Three minute and it's Jordan Pollock with the crutch shot. Yeah. This thing's making weird noises. And it's burning my face. Jeez. Turn off. Thank you. I just took properly. Yeah, and my other near-death experience, I had so many. And most of them was with Finley. Finn, if you're watching this video, I want to see you making the same video saying the near-death experience I had. This mole on my neck is so annoying. There you go, another crutch shot. Want to see that in comments. And I have so many near-death experience. It's like life was made to kill me. Alright, I'm gonna quickly fix this. There you go, another crush shot. How about you work from there? Alright, good. I hope the camera doesn't focus on that thing. Yeah, so I have this memory when I was a little kid. Still am. I was like, I don't know how many. So I'm at my grandparents' apartment. And then So, me and my friend just hanging out. It's not Finn, it's just my childhood friend. So we're just hanging out. And then I was walking like backwards, I didn't know where I was going. And I tripped over their little stump. These days they have a railing there, but then they didn't. And I tripped, and there's like a little, like, just hill going down there, made of concrete. I rolled down that, and then, so the pumps are like that. It's made from 8 all the way high. So this is my grandma's apartment. They have like apartments there, and then there's just a giant thing there, and there's other apartments like that. It goes like that. So this is my grandma's apartment. I fell down that. It's like a 10-foot drop. Some say I fell, some say my grandma saved me on the edge. Wait, now I think about it, if I fell down, I surely would have broke some bones. Yeah, I didn't break any bones. Speaking of bones, has anybody heard of this scar? Yeah, I'm not talking about ScarL in PUBG. I'm talking about my scar on my arm. So, I was at school. There's a tree ledge that, and then behind that is a bank. So me and my friends jump and hang on to that swing. Yeah. So I was keep on doing that. I fell once, had a little pain in my back, then continued. So I was getting ready to jump. We put some bricks because we wasn't tall enough. So I was jumping. Right when it jumped, my friend pushed me and the bricks like fell down, I think. And I fell on my back, like I fell and then slammed my right in this elbow on the ground. And I destroyed my elbow. That's why I didn't have an operation. And so I was healing. I had 2 metals in my arm. The day went out to take them off, the guy was like, oh, it's sticking out, so we don't need an operation. Okay, it's not gonna burn. So he grabbed the thing, you know, that thing that squeezes to whatever. So he grabbed it, puts it on there, just like trying to take it out. Everywhere it was just full of blood. I'm like, fam, what are you doing? Just get me to an operation. Jesus Christ, that guy was an idiot. Yeah. I have one memory. It was, you know the forest? One of my videos, if you watched it. There's like a place, and then when you look up, there's just a cliff. So they have like rubbish on the top of there. And there was like tiles there, and me and my brother was like building something down there. So I went up there to get tiles. So this is me right here in the edge. It's me trying to kick that tile off so I could get it. I'm like, fam, what am I doing with my life? I was so close to dying. I'm like, still continue. I'm like, and I think about it again. I'm like, dude, what the hell am I doing? It's the edge of a like 20-foot cliff. And I'm still trying to get that tile. Eventually, I got it, but the tile, when it fell down, it broke us. And then I came back down safely, no issues, but that was a near death. I have some experience with Finley, near death. So, one of them is... So there's a hill that we was right down, and there's like cars going past. And my stepbrother was like, dad's like, why are you going down a hill with traffic? He's like, I was getting angry, we were like, oh, screw that. So we just keep on going down. car just passing by, and we're like, hey, what's up, Saka? Me and Finley on the same skateboard. Finley's driving. And so there's like a lorry. There was a shop nearby. There's a lorry that brings stuff in there. I was like, Finn, I'm gonna go underneath that for skateboard. So I laid down on the skateboard, just straight, like on the bed. And then I went under the lorry. It wasn't moving, just staying there. People were bringing stuff in. I was like, I'm gonna go down that. So I did. If you want this 100 likes ends, I will do it part 2 of this video. There's just so much things I did, native experience. Like, there's just so many. I remember this is just a memory. So we was fighting at school, me and Finley. And that kid was like, keep scratching us, like going like that with his nails and strangling us. We were fighting over a den that we had. And then I was like, I did that to him back. And he was like holding his neck. Go like that, his throat, so he couldn't breathe. Yeah, I almost killed him. I was like, I felt bad, so I was like, sorry. He was like, like that, but his voice didn't break. Yeah, he was screaming. I was like, went to see him, sorry, and he was like, he didn't swear. He was just screaming louder when I say sorry. He was my brother's friend as well. Yeah. This thing's kind of getting hot. No, don't care. And by the way, I have a triple setup now. I brought my Xbox from my grandparents. So I have a PC, a PlayStation 4, an Xbox 360. And that's it. Wait. So I have all of these in there. All the sweets. Half, like 75% full. I'm gonna put them all in my mouth. We like to drink with Venice because he's a bit and he does all in it. We like to drink with Venice. Oh. All in my mouth. Look, nothing in here. All in my mouth. I'll be here a while. Gotta drink the peach juice. Oh, when I was in Antalya, I made my aunt so angry. She was like so angry because I did this prank. So we're in a 10th floor apartment in Antalya. It's the city in Turkey. And then, so we was on the 7th floor. We went to visit someone. We was on the 7th floor. And then me, my granddad, and my cousin, the little cousin, he's like 1 or 2 years younger than me. So, oh, it's sunny. I'm home alone, by the way. That's why I freaked out. Got the sledgehammer here that I built. Yeah, so I want to put this joke on it. I was going down. Every floor I went down, I pressed the elevator button. So they had, there was like stopping. One floor they went, door open. And 10 seconds later, door closed. Went down, same. Went down, same. That continues for seven floor. So they were supposed to be down in 20 seconds. And they went down in like a minute or two. They were really angry. I'm home alone, I can scream much as I want. Are you? What's up? I'm home alone, I can fart much as I want. I can fart downstairs, upstairs, anywhere. Even when my parents are around, I can just go and fart. Yeah. I absolutely smashed the thing. Yeah, anyway, continuing. So the security, it was like, what are you doing? This could, like, this elevator could, like, something go wrong and stuff. I'm just like, they're trying not to laugh, but also like, yo, did I do something wrong? I'm like, dude, it's only a prank. So everybody's, like, shouted at me, my uncle, and then my aunt's husbands, my aunt, they're all screaming. And then I'm just like, here, dude, who gives a crap? Like, legit, it's only an elevator. And then, so he's like, my aunt's husband's like, the security is calling you. So I was like, fine, I'll go. Honestly, I literally didn't care. The security could send me to police. I'm like, just take it, I don't care. Like, they're making so much of a big deal out of a prank. I literally don't care. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like it, just click that like button. Please subscribe to my channel. It helps a lot. And I'll see you next time. Bye! Let's hit 100 likes for part 2. Bye!